Yeah. Hi everyone. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Anna Kishan and this is Shada. Yeah. We are color coordinated.
Today we are.
Yes. Well, we're here at Key Change together and in Tallinn Music Week, and you gave a talk yesterday. So inspiring. I'm gonna put the link up so people can look at your TED Talk and everything, but would you like to say something about what it is that you do?
All right. So I'm an electronic music producer and originally a singer, but I learned how to produce my own music and I do that now. And when I perform, I use these gestural controllers, and they're gloves with sensors in them. They're called the Mimio gloves, and they basically let you control any sound or effect. And in my case, I control visual projections as well by moving my body through the air. And that makes electronic music performances really expressive and direct and personal.
Yeah, very. I mean, the little I saw, it was very emotional, I thought, because it was so. I mean, you did. People can see on the video, but you do scales and chords and harmonies, and it was so cool.
Thank you.
But I was wondering, like, since you're doing, really going your own way and creating something new, what drives you to do what you do?
Well, in the first place, it's just music. I just love music, and I love music from the day I was born.
Nice.
I'm really happy that you thought that it was emotional, because that is what it is, and I'm really lucky that I found a tool that let me express that emotion, even if it's electronic and it's made with a computer.
Because you said that it made you feel maybe even more free in a live show than when you did attend the
Oh yeah, totally. Yeah.
But how? I mean, because it's so much, you don't think about it when you're doing it.
Not really, because basically the system that we've designed. So I work for Mimio as well as a developer. So the system we've designed is very flexible. So you make your own connections between your own movement and the sound, and if it doesn't work or you don't like it, you just change it. So it becomes completely custom to how you want to express things.
Wow.
So that's why it's not like once you've figured out what your preferred sound relationships are, it's not super difficult anymore because you've just designed it.
Wow.
And also the music is becomes physically part of you, so whatever you do, you make sounds that I don't know, so that's why
I like the way when you talk about it, it sounds so organic and so simple, but it's really, I mean, it's very advanced.
I'm like a total geek.
So you must have a very high IQ, I was thinking in the session yesterday. I was like, I think you do.
I'm just a nerd.
Yeah, that's good. But what about Key Change? How do you feel about it? Why did you want to join the project?
I think it's a really inspiring project and really important. And I think this weekend all being together made everyone realize how awesome it really is that all of these different women from different angles are coming together and sharing ideas, but also seeing the similarities and feeling sort of empowered. Oh, you're going to this as well and stuff. It's really, really good. One of the things that I really want to get out of it or put back into Key Change is I think the technology angle, and because it's empowered me so much and given me so much freedom and independence that I think it's really important that women don't feel that hurdle to learn about technology and using technology to their advantage to be independent. I just looked on a lot of the post-it notes, so we had to put post-it notes with I am this person, this person, I need help, I did do this, and I need help with this. And I saw with the I need help with this, so many notes of musicians saying I need a producer, I need someone to mix my stuff. And I really hope that I can, through Key Change in some way, help make other female musicians also learn that, you can learn all this stuff, and then you can do it yourself, and then you don't need another person anymore.
We should have a class on that. I got really inspired on doing something, I mean, not that advanced, but at least something like that on my life. live shows, like, because it was so creative, and to be able to create all these harmonies and stuff that you want to have even when you're, because a lot of times I'm on my own, maybe with the piano, but I was thinking about because you, I mean, you're doing something that's really new, and as I understand it, you used to play more like classic band setting.
Yeah.
And have you, I mean, how has it been to go in a new direction and to do something that's very, you know, on the edge of what's happening? And like, has it been easier because you get like more attention for it, or has it been harder?
Yeah, like it has, everything has two sides to it, obviously, but it's been super exciting, yes, because, you know, whenever I play now, most people have never seen this type of technology used before, so I get a lot of like wows. But then hopefully also like, oh, but we also really like your music. Hopefully. So that's been super cool, and it's been really, really great to be so independent, and I make all of my music and my movement sound connections myself. I program everything. And I can totally like decide what I want in my show. The other hand, it's also been quite lonely.
Yeah.
Because you know I do everything by myself, and I like tour a lot by myself. I now have a drummer as well, so that's been super nice.
So
to,
nice
to have another human being in my life on the road.
Not just the gloves.
Yeah, not just the gloves. So it's but yeah. So I hopefully will like integrate more live musicians into the set as well, and then you know, because I also feel like I figured all the tech out, and then what I've mostly found out is really about music, and that's why I'm doing it. So I do want to play with other musicians. So yeah.
I think that's a great finishing line. It's about music. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Bye. Nice to meet you. Bye. Oh, thank you. So